Welcome everyone to RGN here for the Winter Classic 2. And we've been rolling with this all week. Hope you guys were able to catch those previous matches. But here tonight we got Vex Gaming versus Games Academy. And to be fair, just going right out with it, I'm going to predict that Games Academy is just going to straight up take this. But Laser, you got a little bit of insight. To be fair, sometimes we see these guys on an off night.
Yeah, Games Academy, one of the hallmarks of them, in my opinion, have been they can play up and down to their competition, namely Cloud9 and the ridiculous Henny Clutch. But they can also, you know, play down to their competition and fall victim to falling into that whole slump. Well, we'll see how it starts off. I mean, either way, I predict a long or slow victory for Games Academy.
Yeah, so here Bolts was providing a lot of basically feedback that there was going to be an A side take, but instead they were grouped up at Beam, and they were able to take into the bomb site, isolating just the one player at Headshot. So 3-on-3 here. Bolts is still towards A, so eventually he'll come in on the flank, but for the meantime, CTs are going to be worried.
And there's going to be a window here where it's a 3-on-2 for Vex. They need to exploit this, but Phelps, the new member from the bomb site, in another one. This guy 1-on-3 is just hanging on. Phantas looking for somebody to shoot at, but he doesn't want to take the fight with Phelps, and a great round from Games Academy. And that situation didn't even pan out, where Bolts might have not been there in time. So nice round from GA.
Yeah, and Phelps, got to talk about him for a moment. He is one of the new additions to the Games Academy lineup. Again, not too long ago, we had some player shifting going on between Luminosity and Games Academy. Some players going up, Bolts coming on down from Luminosity. So, and then Phelps coming in from one of the other kind of up there Brazilian lineups, is my understanding. So anyhow, he's doing big things already here. He's only played, I think, 3 matches thus far with the lineup, but at least that's what I was getting from some of the stats I was looking at. But here we go. Going to be Games Academy anti-eco towards A. They haven't done a lot of reconnaissance, but holy nades, Batman. They're going to take a lot of damage on the CT side before the take even comes in. And well, we got kill point. Last one will take down Phelps, 1v3.
It was a fourth spot here, so Vex definitely wants more than 2 frags. I did like the fact that Vex all went together and tried to create that chaotic scenario on the retake, but Games Academy just had eyes on everything. So that's going to be 2-0, and Vex, with that force buy and the economy I see on them, nobody's saving up for an AWP as well. Things I always talk about on cash, when you force buy on that second round CT side, you're not going to have a lot of utility, namely incendiaries for retakes. And we see that scenario pan out time and time again, when it's first gun round, a retake on A is necessary, and then it's just a quick, big start for the T side.
So, Games Academy, I'm looking to send at least Bolts into A main. Actually, I'm going to send the bomb with them as well. Taking a look at middle just a bit here. And there is an A-side stack, so this is worrisome if Henny and Bolts decide to actually commit. Bolts will. See, Henny is not leaving A main, though. So that's the part I was worried about. Finally, they're looking to commit. But that's because they've got some players coming up highway. And, yeah, they're able to basically just surround the bombsite. Still, they did enter into the stack, but only going to lose Phelps. Not the end of the world, but a bit of economic damage.
So, automatics across the board for Vex. No incendiaries, as mentioned. And that deadly op of Henny. Hopefully, we get a show. I mean, we've had some crazy clutches witnessed from this guy. And it's always exciting to see this man up. What's the first strat from Games Academy? And for the Vex side, we have 2-2 middle as well as A and a mid-stack, actually. 3 here to begin with. And Games Academy just going spread out and putting some pressure towards A main. But where the bomb is, I don't see a commitment coming quickly.
So Bolts finding the first frag, Manta going down. It's an excellent way to start off here from the squeaky door location. And Bolts looks to be that player for the T side, just providing a lot of just noise and making them think that there could be some sort of action towards A. To be fair, we do have Phelps already at 4. His barrel is showing, and he'll go down. So he'll lose a member now, 4-on-4, and actually falling is Henny. Bolts goes down through the door, and this round falling apart a little bit here.
Yeah, janky round from the Brazilians. It didn't look like they were really planning on committing based on the numbers they had. Yeah, and then when the first guy died, the second guy wanted to make up for it and go for the trade, which just resulted in a further deficit. Showtime, though, he is in a one-on-two, but he has so little HP, and with an op, probably going to give up this frag. No, misses. Are both players missing? Just one bullet, all required for this Vex player. Phantas, sitting at fork, and now Showtime has position on him. Does he have time to do this? I think he barely has enough.
Yeah, and now it's going to be a foot race. Phantas going to know right from the get-go that he is heading all the way over. At least he can safely assume, unless he went around squeaky, or he's just waiting for the CT. One of the two, but as we can see, Showtime getting that bomb set in B, and he doesn't know how close the CT was, so just planning it safe. Understandable. He's got 4 hit points as well. Can't blame him for being cautious, but here we go, dropping into checkered 1v1.
I think Showtime just heard him. He's going to peek around. Phantas just about to go up the ramp. Showtime peeking wide, and he gets the clutch. Showtime steals that round away from Vex. And that player at Truck, if he goes down, unless there's a trade attempted immediately, Showtime has a lot of room to work with. And if you're that Vex player at Forklift, it's really hard to predict what Showtime's going to do in that situation. Just got to take a gamble, and unfortunately, he went the wrong way.
Yeah, massive play from Showtime there. Absolutely huge, and that's a round that Vex, they certainly they wanted, and very demoralizing to drop it. Now they actually go for a bit of a force up. They still have a little bit of money left over, but pistol armor, got a scout on the field as well. And at the moment, looks like we're going to have another dedicated A-side play. They don't have anybody, or Lucas is watching the flank, but only from A main, so from that close angle, they could be making their way through B in theory, and gathering that kind of intel. But first player goes down in bolds as he tried to make out onto A, a little bit of information gathering there, but not shifting at all here. This game's Academy.
No, not at all. Just going to stay committed. We do have a player flanking. Lucas denies that entrance. They're going to commit 4-on-4 here into A. I suppose I got everybody here. So does Vex. But the CTs, wow, just can't get a single frag. Games Academy running right through him. Lucas gets his second with the Molotov in the end, and that's 5-0 for the Brazilians. But going back to that one-on-two, it's rounds like those that Vex, if they're going to beat the Brazilians here, really need to pick up.
Indeed. So, as we can see, they bought just enough in the last round, or small enough amount that they can still buy here, is what I was going for. So, up on the field, they are hurting the utility department a little bit. They're going to go for a bit of a middle aggressive play. Got one up in vents, one underneath the boost. Mantas with his op just trained on boost at the moment. Games Academy, though, shifting up their strategy a little bit here. This time we're seeing a little bit more of a spread out play. And again, Bolts will be that player towards Squeaky. But he's going to fall back, regroup with the team. They got plenty of time here.
Who is leaking our info, Chad? This is not okay. Some guy going crazy in the chat right now.
Right.
But he's clearly a Brazilian fan. I know that much. Somebody, we must find this leak, Chad. We must find it. But Games Academy getting back into the match here. They're shifting over towards the B side. Not a lot of counter nades for Vex here. So this setup from the Brazilian, they're not going to meet a lot of opposition in the B bomb site in terms of your utility. So this should be a Brazilian round.
Indeed, as you can see, you're going to have to dodge some Molotovs here inside of the bomb site. Vex spraying into the smoke. Bolts is just planning in front site. Lucas just jumps over the boxes. They don't realize that Killboy is still in the back of the bomb site, and that could be their demise here as he takes down two. But it is a bomb plant that is prime for basically anywhere outside of the
Everywhere.
Bomb site. And Whiter just shot at his own teammate. A little bit of, I don't want to play there, but tapping the bomb. Phelps comes in from CT spawn. He will go down. Now it's up to Henny. Is sticking the bomb here, but doesn't make a difference. Fighter takes down Henny, and that's going to be the round. First one for Vex.
Really surprised Phelps in that situation kept peeking because he saw that Killboy wasn't on the bomb. He saw his barrel clearly off of it and kind of off to the side. So the fact that he took that fight makes them, or puts Henny in a really bad position in that one-on-two. Especially that player up top, really difficult position to pre-fire all the while. So, first round for Vex, but they didn't survive with too many players. Two to be exact, so this round is critical. If they have any chance in this match, it's going to have to be now. They have to make this 2-5, put the Brazilians on the save. If they get put in a double save scenario here, we're looking at What, 8-1? That's or 7 or 8-1? That's not a good look.
Not at all. Bolt's getting tagged up through the squeaky door just a little bit here. Max is going to drop an incendiary on his location. This is as nades are coming over, so we'll see how this is going to work out. They still can't execute just yet. Gonna have to wait that out a little bit more, but here we go. Jumping through that smoke at Fens. They spotted the player on safe box. That Molotov didn't reach him. My Manta and Fighter both getting frags, and now it's just Games Academy trying to dive bomb through these smokes. And as we can see, it did not work out.
Yeah, not at all. The smokes not working against the Brazilians there in Annie versus 4. Okay, there's the first shot. Don't give this man a chance. All right, succumbs to the flame. And 2-5. Now for Vex, and they pick up the round that's going to give them a chance in this match. They lose that one. I wasn't going to say it, but in my mind, I'm pretty much already counting them out going down to that deficit. And with no plant and with this economy, Brazilians will buy. It's not going to be the greatest, but with Tech Nines, these guys can swing that momentum. And still, Vex hasn't built the greatest of economies. The Brazilians haven't visited mid yet, so it's time to take a trip over here. Or at least I thought they were right away. They did get the boost up. That's Phelps with the AK. Doesn't see much. He does have support down below from Lucas, if anybody is close. But I'm surprised the Brazilians went for like a pick-and-roll style strat, given that they have Tech Nines.
Yeah, interesting decision. You see Bolts towards Squeaky. Phelps looking to get aggressive towards a main. They've got Fighter up on the Shroud boost spot inside of A. So they're going to have to watch out for that. Popping open Squeaky Door here is Bolts. He's going to drop a smoke and a flash as well. Really nice flash. Fully white screen and player in the back of the bomb site, and they check Fighter immediately. I wonder if Bolts got there quick enough to hear that boost, because that was an excellent pick.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you could assume that. Otherwise, he just had an amazing read, which would be, right. I mean, sure death if you get it wrong. So must have had that information. At least high probability that they did. In Games Academy, they love going towards this A bomb site, and with the pick already, it's going to be a little tender for the CT side. As we have Manta just about to peek towards quad. Ooh, get spotted out. This fight would be huge if he loses it, but he does get it, evening out the numbers. That's Phelps the victim. But still, this A bomb site, they only have one player here as the highway member rotates, and that's two. The truck is going to take a while to get there. Manta through the squeaky. Didn't even know he was there. Manta with three, but evened out at mid by any.
Yeah, now Henny and Lucas. Last two up, Lucas coming from Vence. He lets a pre-fire go towards Z, but Fantas doesn't look. He gets a flick of a lifetime, though. That was an excellent way to deal with them. Now only Henny left on the field as he takes down Killpoy. Very low hit points left on Fantas, not having any of it. Henny takes him down, and, well, he's gifted an op for his efforts. And as we can see, CT side, that don't necessarily have a great economy to deal with that loss.
This is a really hard spot for Vex economically, because they know the Brazilians are low themselves, but you're only going to have three weapons. In my mind, this is a necessary risk, because even if you save one, your other two players are still not going to have a lot. They're still going to be looking at Famas's in the next round, but they're going to play the safer route. It's just, I feel like if they're going to beat Games Academy, they're going to need a lead coming into the second half. And by doing this, they're just one round away from giving up the lead guaranteed coming into the next. So I disagree with this. However, maybe they can win out. They're going to need to if they're saving for on this round.
Yeah, and I do believe we are having... Yeah, so we're switching to a new server. That's exactly what we're doing. So switching to a new server at 6-2. Unfortunately, there has been a leak of our GoTV. It happens. So, again, not sure how, but it happens. So instead of having these guys play on this one with potential issues going on, Steve let us know that there's quite a few people trying to connect to it. So good idea for us to switch on over to something else. So they are going to do that right away. So hang tight, guys. As again, once we get back into it, we'll be the same scoreline. Nothing changing in that respect. But just have to wait for a match medic here. And actually, I will take the moment to do one of our plugs, one of our giveaways. If you guys are interested, we've got a StatTrak Factory new Desert Eagle Golden Koi on Twitter being given away. So if you guys want to get in on that, again, jump on over to Twitter. Go ahead, first and foremost, follow us at GoRGNTV. And you'll see front and center the tweet specifically that talks about that golden koi. From there, retweet that for one, but you'll need to follow one more account, and that's at spy_Jeremy9000. He is the courteous individual which has given that to us to give it away. So again, shout out to him, and hopefully you guys can enter on in. The winner will be announced on the 14th. So I think we are going to take a very short break here, guys. As again, we're just getting a new server set up for these guys, so could be a minute or two. But when we return, we will continue, of course, with map number one. And it is 6-2, the scoreline with Games Academy in the lead. So don't go too far, guys. We'll be back in just a couple. All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Moving back into map number one here. We apologize for the delay, but again, there was a bit of a GoTV leak. And again, to avoid problems, we just decided to basically solve the problem. So on a new server, very select people have an information to this, and we're ready to go. So 6-2, Games Academy doing big things on the T side. Last we saw, survived with one player and won the last round. So see, Vex hurting a little bit in the form of economy. Gonna be on a save here.
And if Killpo can, that's two frags for Killpo, and that puts the brakes on the Brazilians. They don't even want none of it. Killpo's gonna fall back into the site, and now 3-on-5. Yeah, they have weapons, but the Brazilians have a big player deficit to make up, and their answer to this is to go extremely passive and hope that Vex will continue to push. But I like the fact that Vex, despite not having weapons, is just gonna sit on this player advantage, because hopefully they'll be able to trade out. But I still think they should attempt some sort of stack, because if the Brazilians just hit back into B, they still have a big advantage.
Yeah, indeed they do. Only a P250 on the bomb site itself. Well, Matt is actually holding the cross as well with 5-7, but yeah, as we've seen highlighted already. So they're going to head back towards middle. Not a bad idea, considering he got rifles they don't. Try and work that long range if at all possible. And they're going to break up towards highway. It looks like they will attempt to execute up onto A. So this is going to come down to can Vex react in time. Both falls. And they're going to have a bit of a triangle here and a player from Z. And that's very quickly going to end the round. As now they can go collect weapons from the fallen Games Academy members. And that's definitely the way they wanted to see that round go.
All right, if I'm Games Academy, I'm blaming the server right now.
Right.
For that eco round. gotta be demand a new server. But Vex, Killpo at the bomb site, the smoke worked out so well for him, and the Brazilians were walking through it, ends up giving two kills. But if the Brazilians push through, yeah, they risk giving Killpo even more. But the B bomb site would have been open at that point, because Killpo was the only player there. Of course, the Brazilians can't know that. They decide to fall back, and when they hit back towards connector, nice play by Fantas to drop the first player coming up highway and keeping himself alive for the next. But the Brazilians going with the pop flash into the A bomb site. Manta eventually will fall, but Fighter still alive and well at quad.
Oh, wow.
Eventually traded off as well, but that second spam, wall blind. Excellent.
Yeah, that one onto Phelps. Jeez. Still widescreener coming out of it, and just right before he goes down. Just one more headshot coming in, and it's going to be the round. Only losing two, not the end of the world.
I forgot to note as well, that was the first round on an anti-eco or anti-force that Games Academy has not gone A. That's why we saw Vex stack four players there. That makes the play by Killpo all that more that amazing.
Yeah, no doubt. As we'll see, tons of equipment out on the CT side. Full save coming in, or pretty darn close to it, on the T side. They're pretty spread out right now. Henny with the bomb. He's got Phelps with him as well. Player towards Squeaky here in Bolds. But they still have Showtime and Lucas in positions, making sure that CTs don't get aggressive. But interesting. So they're going to commit and leave the bomb in A main. I really don't know what's going on here. But, well, Henny at least has made his way onto Toxic Barrel in sight. We'll see if he can do something with it.
Yeah, I'm wondering if they just left it there for... I thought they were going to rush in and then leave it there for a player to pick it up and then go for the QB sneak, like Flea Flicker. I don't know if you know what that is, Chad, but yeah, it's one of those kind of plays. But if you're going to do that, why not just have a player with the bomb anyways and just have him come up later? Nonetheless, an interesting round by the Brazilians.
Yeah, looked like in the end, just decided to send some players into B, and then they were hoping that, well, Bolts, for example, got one. I think they want a little bit more out of the people that were over towards A, catching some rotators out, and maybe getting the bomb after.
Okay, this would explain why. But
that would definitely explain why. Team speak problem. Okay, that, all right. I'm a little more sane than I thought I was.
Right, otherwise.
I just did not understand. I'm like, there's got to be something that I'm missing here.
Yeah, the Brazilians, maybe I thought we were seeing the new meta or something being developed in front of our own eyes. Not the case, though. Just going to fix that team speak. I mean, I'm wondering what everybody's consensus is while we have this pause. What's the best voice program anymore? Because at first it was Vent, and then it went to Mumble, and then TeamSpeak made a catch up. Now we got Discord. I don't know, Chad. Right.
I don't know either. I've been using a little bit of Discord, and it's been not too bad for a free software. It's not bad. I've definitely had some voice quality issues, but I think as of now, I am personally a TeamSpeak fan. There's still a special place in my heart for Ventrilo, though. God, love that software.
Anyhow. I'll never forget that noise.
Right?
All right, Brazilians going back towards middle. Lucas finds his way out a blind. Wow. Zoo lead, and then Manta, his second victim. That was quick from Lucas. Vantus making up for it, but he is locked down at the sandbags. He has to look above him. Lucas, that's going to be the third in heavy map control towards the Brazilians.
And he might not be done here. He spotted Kilpo towards Z connector. And won't be able to find the shot, but they're executing into B. They've dropped the CT spawn smoke already. Things are looking very good here for Games Academy. They leave Henny up on the boost, one of the most opportune places to cut off that rotate from middle. Not that we can see any CTs heading that way, but he has all the information in the world that there's no way they're coming towards Vents.
Oh yeah, that spot's fantastic for denying any sort of flank, because not only can he see behind him towards a main, he also has an off angle at middle. Even if one of the members of Vex knew he was up there, it's a difficult spot to pre-fire because there's so many different angles you can take, which are all advantageous. That's Fighter trying to hang on with his rifle, maybe strip some weapons away from the Brazilians. Not gonna be so. So Vex, they do have a decent bank built up. It all started with an eco round, so they're gonna have another goodbye come out. And maybe if they could win this one, the Brazilians don't have that great of an economy. They still have a chance to pull away at 8-7. And I think that's what's gonna need to happen if they're gonna have a chance of winning.
Yeah, I completely agree. To perform, I would say definitely an upset here. Need to be able to take those critical momentum guiding notes. And, well, this is definitely one of them. Both teams fairly low in the form of economy. Games Academy really could finish with a dominant scoreline here. They can take this round. Money on that CT side. So here we go. As we can see, Games Academy very spread out at the moment. Lucas just holding it down middle towards red box. He will smoke it again from that CT side. We'll see if Lucas wants to get aggressive. He does have... Okay, he's going to put down a forward smoke and a Molotov underneath the boost. So the wall of smoke comes in and a pop flash. Beautiful one as well. The player towards Vents fully blind. Lucas takes him down yet again. That is so frustrating on that CT side.
Back to back. Yeah, Zuli gives that up. That's his mark. He needs to come up from there. And Lucas through the smoke. Just doesn't even matter. Kilpo not having the same success he did with that P250 round. And Zuli, that's, you can't let that happen, especially two times in a row. He heard the pop flash coming, and then he doesn't decide to spray. When the last time that happened, it was another instantaneous bust by the Brazilian. So maybe that's not the best option for him. And giving that up this late in the game, that's probably just going to be a Brazilian victory.
It's looking good for them. They're going to take their eighth round here. Vantos might, well, he's getting very aggressive with this op. He's actually moving away from, I guess he doesn't want to be locked in CT spawn, but at the same time, he was drifting towards a more threatening position. I don't know if he's aware there was someone in middle, but neither here nor there. He will fall. Not going to bring that weapon into the next round, and we can see CTs are a little broke. So 14th round, save and I guess get the best buy next round. That's looking to be the case.
So now that the Brazilians are presented with another anti-eco or anti-force, I was wondering if they're going to be headstrong and just hit that B-bomb site. But no, they're going to go back to A or middle. This is something they haven't done on the anti-eco or force either. And if they go too quickly into A, this may be problematic. Vex, with a ton of people, they might get the bomb off of this.
Oh man, Bold's getting a triple spray down though. Salvaging the situation. He lost Henny. But he will be able to deal with the rest. So fighter coming up on the flank from a main. And Bolts is actually hanging around for it. He might be able to complete his quad kill. And indeed he does. Four on the round. Four Bolts. And I like the idea from Vex, to be fair. That's kind of what you're hoping to see. Bomb carrier, and maybe you'd like him to be alone. But that's going to be that. This game's Academy move up to 9 rounds. And Vex only on 5 on their CT front. Not a good look, but they do have a chance to make it 6 rounds.
Yeah, that's about as good of a situation as you can ask for on an eco round. You'd 4 on 2, potentially can get the bomb as well as some guns. But Bolts just showed up. Former Luminosity member. Showing why there. There's Games Academy visiting the A-bomb site another time. One player here for the time being. No Fantasy is watching the door, but I presume a smoke will be out. So isolated in the bomb site. Penny taking the fight before the smoke goes up.
Now they're executing onto the bomb site. Zoo lead going up onto the catwalk. Bolt finally comes up with a refrag here. Lucas with the bomb. This is pretty ballsy to be jumping up on a red box. He's not going to fully commit to it, and I like that. As again, if he gets up onto the red box, he is visible from all angles, and he's got the bomb. So on top of that, he is the only player with 100 HP. So we'll see if they can find any picks. They basically stalled to try and find something. And Vex isn't giving them a lot to look at here. Showtime, I think, spotted one, but he'll go down. Lucas now about to be blindsided. Fighter getting both of those, and it leaves Bolts in a pretty awkward spot.
Yeah, it may seem futile at this point with 16 HP falling back towards A main. He's going to attempt it. He's going to need a lot of mistakes coming out from the Vex side, and Spider gave him a chance. That's something you don't want to see, and we were talking about that earlier today. It was, or was it yesterday? It was so impressive to see a 4-1 with nobody peeking here on this soil, but not today.
Yeah, it was 9-6 at halftime. Brazilians with pretty darn good lead on their T front. Again, I do believe, yeah, this was their map choice. Mirage again coming up next. To be fair, though, Games Academy pretty damn strong on Mirage. So see how that one turns out. Not there yet, though. Vex Gaming, again, with only 6 on their CT front. Pistol round, pretty darn crucial with the scoreline, as otherwise could find themselves half the scoreline, 12-6, and then fighting their way on back. So not a place you want to find yourself in. And again, like we talked about, you want that upset to come to fruition. That you definitely want to find as much momentum as you can. It's just not going their way.
Yeah, Vex loses pistol round and doesn't get the force by. Thereafter, that's it. That's it. I just don't see them getting that many rounds on the T side. With such stars on the side of Games Academy, like Bolts with the rifle, probably going to see a couple of solid sight holds from him by himself. But Vex, one of their last chances here in my eyes if they don't start getting that momentum early. And a pause, Chad. What is this about?
All right, TeamSpeak again, apparently.
Your favorite program is getting exposed right now.
Right? This is not looking good for me. Well,
this is a free Mumble advertisement.
Whoever their server provider is, don't go with them. No, I'm joking.
Oh, I suppose it is the server being exposed.
Yeah, I imagine it's a server-side issue. Who knows? Maybe it's client-side. I do not know. But it looks like they have it sorted out, and I'm glad to hear it. But if they continue to have problems, probably want to find a new server. But here we go. Back alive into the pistol round. As we'll see the equipment double kits here on Games Academy. Just seeing that more and more often. But tis what it is. Talked about it a little bit earlier today. Couldn't really figure it out, though, to be honest. Not a lot of theories there, considering the only thing that's changed is there's actually more time on that bomb defusal. But nonetheless, gonna see two of those on the field, and they're gonna be playing retake on A.
So Bolts, blessed with a big chance, depending on when Vex uses this smoke, and it will be early. So Vex is gonna have a window. He just has to not get blind, but two smokes up. I missed that second one, so that's gonna grant Vex entry into the bomb site. They do, the Brazilians have two smokes in their hands for the retake. No flashes to note, though, so this is going to be problematic.
And Showtime goes down already. He was on top of I still don't know what you call it, like the outhouse on highway. Anyhow, he's up on top of that, jumps up from E-Box. Found a nice angle between the smokes, but couldn't capitalize. Bolt's gonna fall next. Ooh, this is not looking good for James Academy. Phelps, the last one, and a flawless pistol. And that's kind of the downside of playing retakes is, kind of, at least in my experience, either goes really well or not well at all. And you can see that was one of the rounds that James Academy couldn't really make it work.
And you're hoping that your one guy at A might be able to find ahead through the smoke as they're coming in, but not the case at all. And with the rest of the kills, just missing some shots for the Brazilians, nice shots from Vex, no flashes for the retake as well. So exactly what Vex needed to have a good shot in this match. And now the second part to avoid the force buy coming out from the Brazilians. And he doesn't have enough for a scout as well, and we've seen him do work with that. How much does he save? Does he even buy into this? Okay, he does go with the P250, and we'll see what the Brazilians opt to do. So far, minor A stack.
That looks to be the case. One player in Lucas on the B bomb site.
Double
everybody
boost.
Else. Ooh, here we go. So we got Henny, one of the boxes, actually up on red box now, and Bolts on the shoulder of Showtime over at A. Phelps just going to be overseeing the whole thing. He's the manager on duty.
You know, this just puts a big smile on my face, Chad. These innovative ecos, that's what I like to see. I like this.
Yeah, no, this is some cool stuff. See if it works out for them. Obviously, Henny's a little vulnerable. By a little, I mean a lot vulnerable from highway. That's why he's pre-aiming that direction. So if they do decide to take that real estate first, this might not work out so well. But to be fair, that's kind of same to be said about a lot of A stacks. But
this is shaping up to be a hard commitment here from Vex, and they haven't done any scouting. So they're going to run straight into this. But since one player is boosted, they're going to know at least one more is inside of the bomb site. How quickly do they identify that it's a stack? And will it even matter? Zuli onto two Manta, then with another one, Phelps. Gonna try to do something with the 5-7. He's found a window. That's gonna be three for Phelps. That third shot was amazing. And Fighter will trade. Now Lucas.
That was unreal. And he almost got out of there too, trying to play with that smoke, but leaves it to Lucas. He does have armor, and he's close enough that time is not necessarily of the essence. As he'll slowly approach, now lets his position be known. There is some rifles in front sight, but I don't know if they're going to let him up that far. They're both peeking currently, one from the left side. Lucas takes down the first, but the long-range MAC-10. Fanta's able to salvage the round, but that got very threatening. And yeah, you can see how effective that would have been if the first three players did not die immediately. Like, Thub just went nuts. Anybody else left on that bomb site probably would have been a Games Academy round, but they lost a lot just in the way the entry frags came in.
Yeah, that's about as good as it gets, considering how the round started, besides winning the round. And Phelps, man, he created something out of nothing. I mean, he just found the gap and he shot it. I didn't expect him to get more than one, if any, because they knew he was there.
So now on Eco, looking for the squeaky push, Manta, putting up a brick wall, though. He's got 16 hit points, so he is a little low. Phelps not interested in pursuing further. Fighter getting into a long-range duel with Showtime. Takes a little bit of damage, but not looking like a good eco thus far. Need to do some sort of damage. Phelps still inside of Squeaky, so maybe he can come up with something, but yeah, both remaining CTs so low.
He came out guns blazing. I don't know why you pre-fire in that situation, but Phelps, I guess he thought that if he opened up the door right away, somebody would be looking at him, but didn't get the kills. Another big one for Games Academy. This is the most dangerous gun round on the CT side, in my opinion. Again, after you go for the force buy, your utility isn't right for the retakes, and the incendiaries, which the Brazilians will definitely be using later on whenever they have money. But first strat for Vex. They try to go for the boost. Unfortunately, Fighter cannot make it up onto his teammate's head. Or do they just not want to do it right away? I'm not sure. But both hoppers miss.
Yeah, both with that shot. That could have been a massive opening for either side. But instead, going to be whiffs. Fanta's still looking over the top at boost. But we can see that the op of Henny has rerouted. He's actually all the way over at quad already. So they're going to leave middle open. And this isn't a bad idea, to be fair. You just need to be very weary of mid. You can't be blindside. Oh, no one called that they went through Z or time. You got to be aware that real estate is open, but that's currently what they're allowing for the T side, but T's haven't actually taken it.
Yeah, you need to spend a lot of time clearing it as well, because it's not like you'd expect a player to just fall back and relinquish the spot immediately upon spotting. But now they're going to realize that as Eni goes down at the A side. This is going to put a question into Vex's head. Now what is the setup? What's open? Why is Eni over there? But they're going to commit onto the B entrance. And we do have two CTs here, and they are both eliminated quickly. Vex, T side. I didn't say it was enough, but they're proving me wrong so far.
Yeah, big round for them there. And I don't know if you spot that shot from Killpoy. He was pre-firing around the corner at B, kind of towards headshot, and flicked back to CT mid-spray. Just headshot Lucas. Really ridiculous shot. But anyhow, impressive nonetheless, as got Games Academy now down. It's going to be 10-9, double digits for Vex. And, well, they're going to have a round where there's not a lot in the form of equipment here for Games Academy, so definitely need to take rounds like this and do it, keeping many players left up, just further that advantage.
Last time there was a round like this too, Games Academy got as close as you could possibly get to winning the round with these 5-7s, and this time they don't have that big of a stack. They are stacked towards the B side, but not that many players. Vex could do a better job of scouting into these bomb sites before they commit. And I think they're going to go for just another hard commitment, this time towards B, so Games Academy have been 2-for-2 on these sort of rounds thus far on the CT side, guessing the right bomb site, stacking the most players there, but this time only 3, not 4.
On Henny, speaking in a way that Fanta's crouch beats him, we'll be able to take him down, but Phelps, alive and B, will go down, only taking one this time. But Lucas, still one to worry about. Showtime comes out to the vents, but dealt with by the B main player. And it's only Bolts remaining. It's going to be coming up from CT spawn here. Looks like we will have a pause being called for the T side. Not sure what that's about. I'm sure we'll know very soon. Bolts, nice lineup of that off angle. We'll net him an AK. And at this point, I think he'll just get out of here.
Yeah, he has a couple options. He can either go for frags and keep that economy low of Vex to try to put them in a spot where they'd have to buy if they lose the next round, or save the AK and not have to buy himself an M4. Goes for the exit frags, gets punished for it. So Vex is going to still have a big economy, and Games Academy after this buy are still going to be pretty broke. And taking a look at the buy thus far of Games Academy, you see right when they can afford it, we see those incendiaries.
Definitely, and like you have highlighted, so critical on a map like this, more so than other maps, to be fair. Just so many places to neatly tuck those Molotovs and incendiaries, and yeah, without them, honestly, it's very difficult to, on the offense or on the defense, to be fair. It's become so popular on anti-ecos just to flood the A-bomb site with Molotovs and such, so we do have a player from the Vex side. Manta was having some FPS issues, so it looks like he's just going to be rebooting his computer. That is our understanding anyhow. So hopefully he can get those resolved, as, of course, we want everybody playing at good FPS. We're very spoiled these days, Laser. We need to be playing at 300 FPS, 144 hertz.
Oh,
I don't have that.
Let me tell you, Chad. I did not. I just this year, for the first time ever, have gotten a 144 hertz monitor. Anything above 85, I was rocking the same Dell monitor because that sucker was like 11 inches and could crank out 85 hertz. I was rocking that thing for almost a decade.
Yep. And
now we live in the spoiled days, as you just said. I looked at this thing and I haven't stopped crying since. It's just beautiful.
Yeah, it honestly is. The difference between, if you guys haven't, just to go off on a tangent, if you guys haven't, there's some people that are like, it's probably not that big of a difference. I don't need 144 hertz or 120 hertz even. You're definitely missing out. There's no doubt that it is a beautiful, beautiful thing. And yeah, just to kind of further what you're talking about, those old CRT monitors, they used to be higher than 60 hertz. So like people back playing older iterations of the game used to be used to the higher refresh rate as well. So we're just now actually designing our flat inch screens to be able to do that. And I don't even know if it was intentional in that, like, obviously 144 hertz and 120 hertz required for 3D. And I think that was the motivation to put them in new monitors. But now everybody's like, damn, this is great for gaming. and it's continued. So
yeah, even the difference from 60 to 85, which the CRTs could put out, was miles different. So up to 120. Yeah, you look at any of the old LAN videos. So we're talking 05 and before, and it's predominantly all CRTs.
Yeah. It was definitely an advantageous thing. And I'm sure there's people still out there with CRT giant tube monitors.
speaking of the old movies, the old Shagwire movie, but I forget which TV program it was on. I want to say MTV, but I could be wrong. Anyways, I saw him. I was watching a poker stream, and I saw him on there, and I was like, "Wow, this guy's just killing it from Counter-Strike to professional poker player."
There's a couple of people that make that work. I think there's some StarCraft II pros that have kind of gone between like poker and StarCraft II, and yeah, it's interesting. Yeah. So yeah, very very intriguing how poker is almost like a bridging between like a normal. Well,
the similarities between poker is so evident once you start playing poker a little bit, like judging situations and risk management, just two very big things in Counter-Strike, and I think a lot of people see it as a natural transition, not so natural to PTR. Shots fired.
Shots fired indeed. So again, guys, if you're just joining us, this is not a RGN talk show, as much as we'd love to do one. We are just waiting for a fifth member to come back in for Vex Gaming. He's having some FPS issues, and I guess he just needed to reboot his computer. So again, still just waiting on that. But Vex, they have taken the lead here. You can see they've yet to drop a single T round. They've been able to string five in a row. So,
And the closest the Brazilians have gotten has came with a force buy, and they haven't gotten much done since, so it's kind of worrying for them, especially they haven't built up that great of an economy yet at all.
Yeah, so this is a massive round here. Games Academy really need to grab a foothold on the CT side if they want to take it again. This is their map choice, so big victory here if Vex can pick this up moving into their own map choice in Mirage. To be fair, though, like we were talking about earlier, Mirage definitely not a bad pick for the Brazil or bad map for the Brazilians either. So, see how that one plays out once we hit that. But here we go. Match is now unpaused. We're ready to rock. And Games Academy again. All the nades required. This is their chance.
And I haven't got to watch much of Games Academy since Zeus left for Luminosity. And when I was watching them, it was very distinct, more so than any other team, how much of a role he played in-game as a coach. And without him, that also kind of, I was thinking it was going to affect their T side more, but he would make calls on the CT side as well, from my understanding, and that's just crazy. So without him, it's probably going to be a big adjustment to make. I don't know how much they've played since the departure. All right, we'll see what happens this round. Once again, Fantas looking for the pick at mid. Spots a glimpse of a player towards white, being Lucas. So the setup from the Brazilians are shifting the op around of any. He's over towards the B side. Opening pick from Showtime as Vex beginning to envelop around the A-bomb site. But it's taken them quite a bit, and they've already given up a frag.
Yeah, Manta taking more damage towards Squeaky as well. Killpoy actually kind of lollygagging back over towards B. It looks like they're interested in executing here. No one's actually playing in the bomb site for Games Academy. Could be a little worrisome. We're going to see a smoke go down. Killpoy finds an opening frag in the middle, but traded off Phelps from the vents. Able to do the damage. Lucas moving into quad. He's immediately dealt with by Manta. So 3-on-3. This is definitely a winnable spot for Vex.
This would be a monstrous pickup. Bolt's looking for the planter, but he gets around safely into the Squeaky now. Well, three up. Four Vex still. Even numbers, but now denied by Bolt. Picking up the advantage. Phelps on to Fighter, but now Zulied inside of the bomb site. He has to separate the Brazilians, but he gets flanked by Phelps coming up from mid. And that's a big pickup. But the situation we always paint. Brazilians, since they only survive with two, they need this next round. Their money is going to be at zero. They're going to spend every single dollar with utility. I suppose there's going to be a denomination that they can't spend, but still.
Yeah, but yeah, like it's data draining everything they can there. Whereas on the T side, they have a full buy, everything that they want. So, see how this one plays out. Big round, though, from Games Academy. Yeah, Phelps. Sprayed down one at quad through a smoke, and then just hides at highway, and Zoo just couldn't get eyes on him, so it'll be that round in the books. Now T side. Like fighter, making sure no one gets aggressive towards Squeaky. Fanta's side of A main, making sure no one boosts up over the smoke and gets control of that real estate. So a bit of a slow round thus far from Vex. We'll see if the CT setup can work out. Showtime is taking a lot of damage underneath the drop already.
Yeah, 34. Does have support, of course, from Lucas at the white box. Loves to shift back and forth at highway, but now Vex. Gonna see them open up at mid. Showtime in danger. Tilpo's gonna check
that
it.
That timing.
It's so bad for Showtime. He looks away the moment Tilpo peers above him. And Vex with that frag, they're gonna shift back over to B, but still good numbers here in B. And now Phelps falls in the vent. So just one member with a lot of pressure on him. That's Annie.
Yeah, he's definitely a man that likes his clutches, but
so close.
Takes him down. Yeah, that shot would have continued the string of frags and would have been safe a little longer, but instead now bomb being set. They've got two towards checkered now. Actually, fighter heading towards the pit. He's taking a lot of damage, and he's gonna lose his teammate on the bomb site. Bolts with both of them. Now it's only Fantas. He's got an AWP. Needs to find two 1v1s here, and he'll look away from Vents. As Lucas now jumping out of it, he can't
That's
hit the
huge.
Shot at him. And yeah, getting this positioning for the CT side, going to be very difficult for Fantas. Doesn't expect the flank. Ooh, gets one chance at a shot.
Lucas!
But that's that, Lucas. Oh boy.
Right. One of the brothers not having that good of a round at the end. Took him a while, but eventually he got it done with his mind, not his shots there, Chad. Because the fact that he stayed in the vents that long really put a drain on Fantas' ability to hold the player off of the bomb. So at least he got out of the vents, too. That was a huge play, because Fantas was posting up on it for so long. He goes out of the vents, and Fantas gets the kill. That creates a vastly different situation. But the Brazilians taking another one, but they still haven't got out of that economic danger. At any point, Vex can put him back on a double save.
Oh no, they're gonna miss the run boost over at A. This is gonna look a little awkward. Showtime kind of sharing a spot with one of his teammates. They've got two ops on his bomb site. So this is looking look a little dangerous for the T side, but they're gonna deal with two players. Showtime, though, still lurking towards Fence. Can't find the no scope. And now advantage to Vex.
Yeah, it's pretty bad for Showtime. Now two members left for the Brazilians, Lucas and
Phelps
through the smoke. Zuli playing quad, can't get a kill. And now Fantas, he falls to Phelps as well.
What a
12 round. To 11, that saved them so much this half in this game. Again, if they lost, they're looking at a double save. But still, you see how much Vex built up on their streak, 5 rounds in a row, allowing them another bye. So this is 3 rounds in a row in Games Academy. Still haven't put Vex on the save, and I don't know if they ever can if Vex gets the bomb down.
So, big round. Games Academy, we'll see a pause coming in. Not sure why bomb came to mind, but yeah, pause. I guess we have some sort of microphone issue. I'm being told by our spectator it's not TeamSpeak's fault, so just throwing that out there. One in the point column for chat. So yeah, we gotta get that sorted out, though, obviously. That's communication. Kind of important. But going back to that retake, that's the second time Phelps has just sprayed into the smoke at quad and just killed someone. That, to be fair, Vex, they probably shouldn't feel as safe as they do. And that's why, like, if there's a smoke down there, I guess the idea is you kind of tuck back into that corner. You have a pretty decent angle against someone that would run through that smoke for one, and two, coming off to the left. But yeah, two times now. Phelps able to take advantage of exactly that, them playing in the open. You can see through those things, apparently. And he's honestly been massive in this game thus far. 18 frags on the board. One of the new members here for Games Academy.
Yeah, he's doing big things. And with Taco leaving, got some big shoes to fill. Definitely one of the highlight players of Games Academy. Though I suppose, to be fair, a lot of them can just go off at any point. We've seen them all and do that. And getting bolts in an exchange for who's the last guy that I'm thinking of? Old school guy.
Phoenix,
there we go. Couldn't get his name. But yeah, with bolts, I don't mind that trade at all. And Phelps, I haven't seen enough of him to have like a clear picture painted, but the plays that I've seen him make, he's definitely not underperforming for Games Academy. But Just taking a look at the economy once more, Games Academy, despite winning three in a row, still have not built up enough of a bank to warrant or grant them safety if Vex ever wins a round again. But to be honest, I'm surprised it's gotten this close.
Wondering if Zeus was also in charge of technical problems over at Games Academy, because they're having a lot of those at the moment.
I mean, I suppose they still live close to each other, right? Just give them a call.
Right, exactly. Hey, man, we're having that issue again. Come on over. Apparently, his computer just restarted. Yeah, anyhow, he's going to be coming back, obviously. But everybody right. is having issues at the moment. So, yeah, Games Academy got to invest in some tech support.
On our European side, we had a, what was it, a water closet?
Right. Water closet breaks. Oh, yeah.
Apparently, that's a bathroom.
Yeah, yeah. To be fair, a lot. I thought that everybody knew that. But apparently, I don't know, being that I'm in Canada and we're still kind of attached a little bit to the British and such, I think that's why we know of that a little bit, whereas you guys are just like,
I mean, we still haven't explained it.
A restroom or a bathroom, okay?
A water closet. Anybody said water closet?
I think it's a really old school term. Like, it's when you first had running water and such, it was a water closet because... I don't know. They probably didn't even call it toilets back then. That's just what they,
right.
I think it went from piss pot to water closet. I think that was the jump, and then it maybe got a little more sophisticated from there on out.
That's something I've never thought about in my life. Like the invention of a bathroom.
Yep.
And then I suppose the bath got added to the place where you do your business, and then it's a innovation. I'm sure there was like some controversy about it. Like, why would we want to? Well, where we bathe.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, we also had someone's PC getting taken over during the European matches. Forgot about that. So we've had some crazy stuff going on today.
Yeah.
Definitely some crazy stuff going on. So anyhow.
I suppose, probably shouldn't go there, but I suppose Games Academy could take a water closet break faster considering what the brothers do.
Considering what the brothers...
They went to the bathroom together at Fragadelphia.
Really? They just yeah. Well, your brothers, I suppose.
Yeah.
So what does it matter? I don't
know.
Got
the same gear, I suppose.
Right? Yeah. So there you go. I imagine they probably have multiple washrooms in their house, so they probably don't have to do that. But I have no idea. Cannot confirm.
I just thought it was really strange. I mean, I wasn't creeped out by it. I just never seen that before. It was surprising.
Fair enough. I guess it's very much in the North American culture for like females to kind of go to the washroom together. That's kind of a thing, but males going to the washroom together, not I don't know. Anyhow, very odd and very irrelevant topic.
I took you there, Chad.
But interesting nonetheless. Just a little extra tidbit of information there on the twins. So anyhow, still just waiting for I need to get back into the server. It does not have a solid state drive. Don't think so anyhow. So computer restart taking a little bit longer with that slow working hard drive potentially. But I imagine we'll get back into this very soon. Taking quite a bit to get through map number one, not gonna lie.
Right, we had the leak, which was promptly flex sealed. You seen that product while we have more time to go off on random tangents?
Wait, the what, sorry? The flex seal?
Maybe it's only a USA product, but it's like if there's a leak in anything, it's like a rubber spray.
On
something. I've always just thought of it's like other applications, like you like flex seal somebody's eyes or something as torture or something.
Well, have you tried like that new skin stuff? I've tried that before where you get like a cut or whatever and you just spray. It's like a spray-on Band-Aid.
Okay, Valve, you got it. Weird. Next item.
Right.
The spray-on.
You got little medikits. Can buy yeah. one at the start and spray it on after you take some damage.
That's actually I've seen that innovation. And I watched like a video on it. Okay, no more tangents. Sorry, guys, we're back live. We are back, and another gun round, getting us back into the match. Witnessing Games Academy rally back, but they still haven't built an economy. Vex, despite losing, have kept Games Academy's economy in arm's length. So at any point, Vex wins a round, they could still put Games Academy on the save. And is it going to be a double, potentially a double save, actually, too?
So here we go. Going to see Manta off towards Squeaky. Fighter making sure no one comes up over the boost in middle. No one watching the B flank at the moment. But we're going to boost up over middle. And already a shot ringing out. Fighter taking a lot of damage via Henny and Z. So nice shot. Not the frag maybe he was looking for, but damage dealt nonetheless. Bolts is up on the shroud boost. We'll see if this potential A-take's going to work out at the moment, considering they do have Fanta still towards mid-main, but it looks like an A-side take.
Kilpo, he's looking for the good timing. He's going to flank up Highway. This could be the end of the Brazilians if they're not careful, but they get around in time. Showtime reveals himself, but it could have been worse. It could have been both frags for Kilpo there, but Vex still haven't pulled the trigger. Bolts boosted up. He's going to have a big chance, but Vex is falling back. And all the while, the B player... Second B player is falling off, so Lucas is going to be alone. Okay, he's going to have a teammate.
Okay, we'll have Phelps there with him. But Henny goes down in A. Luckily, Bolt's still there to clean up. And he should be able to. Well, in good time, he's going to know that it's not an A-side hit. And here we go. Phelps onto the first one. Onto Fighter. Lucas peeks out wide. Now only remaining T's stuck in checkered. And this is an awkward position to be in. Kind of focusing on either side. Lucas taking a lot of damage. He does not really need to peek anymore because he's got Phelps with him. And finally, they will be able to take down Phelps, but then Lucas trades off of that death. And picture perfect. Games Academy able to close up the round.
We have another issue coming out from Henny.
Holy Henny. What is going on here?
You remember that time we had when RGN first started, or we first started casting together, and it seemed like we had to delay every single game?
Everyone. Everyone.
So we're spoiled, as well as we're talking about with monitors. We're spoiled nowadays.
Definitely. It's
but
nowhere
one,
near what it used to be.
It's just one player's issue. Come on, Henny, get it together.
Yeah, Henny and his computer having a bad time here, so... Gonna have to wait for him to get back in and
just go rob one of the Luminosity computers.
Right. It's like, guys, come on. We're midway through a match. Can we just borrow it? Our spectator, let us know. Should be back live in just a moment. He's a little bit ahead of us. So hang tight. Games Academy, though, taking four rounds in a row. And that's after five in a row for the Vex side. And to be fair, though, that last round, again, going to be brought down to two members, and because of it, we're going to have a low economy here, and Force Buy coming in from the T's. Not a bad idea, considering they could still put Games Academy on the save.
Yeah, and they're keeping enough to get a goodbye in the next. They'd have everything if they get the bomb down. And Fanta's going to need somebody else to drop him that op next round if that's what he wants to do. But what's the play here from Vex? Three smokes, four flashes, a lot of tech nines, and some hope to back it all as they're down two at 13 to 11. They're running out of chances here. Games Academy, again, still have not built that economy. But a flash for the A-main. Nobody peeks along with it, though, from Games Academy. Big opening for Vex. Two frags, but still two up in the bomb site.
What a round. And that was, I think they peaked, they got counter flash. So a flash went into A main as, or maybe it was a team flash, but both players that were intending to peek that flat, like peek in with that, they got white screen as well. So yeah, that was almost super dangerous for Vex, but instead just the plan foiled. It just did not work out at all. Instead, Games Academy left caught off guard, and well, Vex just storms into the bomb site.
Yeah, I wish I had an instant replay or a rewind function because I'd really like to know exactly what happened. There was a flash imprint by Forklift. I'm not sure if that was the one or was it a self-flash from Games Academy, perhaps just missed timing. I didn't catch it.
Yeah, entirely unsure. Would love to look back at that one, but for another time, I suppose. But the round where Vex could still break the economy of the CT side, but that was it, and they won it. Now Games Academy... They are hard-pressed to purchase anything. Going to be with, well, Bolts has a Deagle. Got two P250s. They went with a bit of a middle stack. They actually have Showtime on the boost. So it's a pretty opportune angle to find a nice flank. They decide to go towards A. Could work out. But at the moment, the B bomb site looks to be the target. At least the bomb is kind of lurking around in B main.
So Games Academy, they're looking at a double save. And... That's going to put Vex really close to victory. And Games Academy is going to have to play out flawless when they finally get their guns out. Unless they want to go for Pharmacist in the next round and not allow Vex up to 14. But that's risky in itself because then the next time they have guns, they're looking at Vex at 15. But Henny goes down clean inside of B. And with that falls a lot of Games Academy's chances to strip any weapons away. They're going to try to focus down Manta. Doing a good job staying alive so far. Might not even go down. Good stuff from Manta. Nice quad kill.
Yeah, very nice quad kill from him. And not a single player will die in that round. Now our questions are answered. FAMAS by. As Games Academy going to bet it here. It looks like we got another pause, laser. So, and it's Henny. How dare you request a pause, Henny? Maybe this is actually a tactical one. Oh, CS. Our spectator is telling us that CS crashed. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, it was bolts this time. All right, we can shift the blame a little bit here, laser.
I'm still upset that Henny is the one who paused.
Right?
That just makes me upset.
He's got no room to be the one pausing.
Yeah. Somebody else.
It's one of the other guys. All right, going to have to wait that out, but considering they are going to be force buying here, taking a look at some of the equipment, for example, Phelps, he has enough to get the FAMAS, and I'm actually intrigued that he goes with a helmet over getting any utility at all, honestly.
Sorry, I was drawing on my mouse pad. Who?
No, I was just saying Phelps, he has a helmet, and that could be used for some sort of utility instead when you can see, well, Fighter does have an M4, but you kind of assume, again, they're utilizing weapons that are probably going to be all one-hit headshot. So
yeah, maybe
probably
fat-fingered it, or I mean, I'd take a smoke PT-50, anything over head armor.
Yeah, well, me as well, but Phelps, on the other hand, worried that someone's going to pull out their pistol and take him down, potentially something to that effect, or just didn't think about it. I have no idea, but we do have.
I think just like saying fat fingered,
right?
It's just a good way to describe it.
Yeah, no fault of his own either. Just accidentally clicked the wrong button. It happens.
Yeah, anyhow. I mean, games. I've never met Phelps. I think it's the only one I've never bumped into. I'm excited. I love all those Brazilians. Anyways, 13-13. We're back. Lucas, the only player without a rifle on the Games Academy side, and they go for the force buy here. This is dangerous, because the next time they'll see a buy if they lose this is for the win for Vex. So they really need to pick up this round. They're going to go with another aim main push? No, they're just going to boost up the old-fashioned way. And I don't think anybody heard that from the Vex side, so at least they'll have one up.
Yeah, Manta's there, but he was pre-firing while they were boosting. So yeah, I'm uncertain if they know of it. If he was completely quiet, there's no doubt he would have heard it. They're hopping right on the other side of the wall there, but we'll find out in good time.
At minimum, he'll make the call that they could be there.
Right, yeah, exactly. So that could be why they're trying to make use of this mid control. Of course, that boost very vulnerable if Highway is in control of the T side. But there's going to be Henny there. He's got to come up big. Takes down the first. It's nice work from him, but now the aid take underway. Now we're going to find out, do they know the boost is there? Bolt's able to take down one. Only going to be one from him, and Showtime will fall as well. Henny chiming in, he will create an advantage, but the bomb being set.
And he is going to get the bomb down cleanly. Henny looking for the kill, can't deny him the escape out of the bomb site, but he's down to just one HP. Zuli can't stay alive, and now Manta. Ooh. Versus three. Make that two. Henny, first one going down, exchanging spam through the door. He can't do it much more, only has 11 HP left. Trying to fight the player at fork, but Phelps, key frag, and keeps the Brazilian in the spot for victory, because if they lost that, they're fighting for the tie.
And that was such a huge round from Henny. We've been bagging on him because of his disconnects and stuff, but, well, he provides a performance when required for his lineup. Again, working that highway positioning, taking down one, and then kind of saving that A-bomb site a little bit as he made his way back up to fork. So big, big round from him, but this game is not done yet. There is a lot better equipment this time around on the CT side. So there's that going for them, but the CT side still have plenty in the form of a bank account here. So we see the op on Fantas, AKs, but it'll be Phelps first and foremost taking down Killpoy. They went with a bit of a gambit play, three pushing aggressively into B main, and well, it worked out just fine.
All right, big gamble. Of course, the B side with three rifles. And unless Vex have a player posted up at the super safe spot back in T spawn, three players is a lot. Unless Vex are like planning a B split and somehow they have three players watching it, it's really hard for that single player to come out with more than one frag, and he just got wrecked on the first one. So Vex disadvantage, but they have mid control as a result, looking to split onto A. Games Academy are completely giving up middle, so they're not even going to peek it at all for intel. So this split. What?
They line up a truck, and well, Fanta's one bullet, two frags. That's gonna be their ticket into the A bomb site here. They still have Annie to deal with. He has to come up massive again. Can't do it though. He does dig quieter, but that AK duel goes his way. Phelps, Lucas remaining. 2-on-3. Two at quad box, and both CTs have incendiaries.
They lose this. They're broke for the rest of the half. They need this 2-on-3. Fantas burning a lot of his HP off at the quad. Both players here. Games Academy can't give up a kill from the quad. One man peeking. That's Fighter. He falls. Do they know the second one theirs, though? That's Zuli. And they smoke off the bomb. I'm wondering if they're going to hop on it. Fantas falls, but Zuli, they haven't identified that he's there. He's good for one. Sticking the bomb is Lucas, and he's going to get it. No, he denies it with a knife. Are you joking? That's insane.
Zuli, that was so close as he stopped spraying. And I thought that in that moment, he misses. Well, he's going for the knife, and there's a crouching player as well, but he found the player model, and he made it work. But that was right down to the very end. And that's the advantage of playing quad, but not having your players actually boost there and give the intel that you have double quad. As, again, they take one down, and it's very difficult to read that he was the last one up.
Yeah, and making up for the ending of the spray, going for the knife, that was so close. I mean, one swipe decided it. I thought, I called it, in my mind, that looked like it was a defuse via how close he got. But no, just in time with the shank. What a game. Comes down to milliseconds with somebody blind shanking into a smoke. Crazy stuff this match. And now Games Academy likely going to be fighting for the tie unless we see some eco magic come out from the Brazilians. And even in the next round, their utility is really going to be hurting. Vex's A-takes have been looking strong. So if it comes down to another retake scenario, Games Academy is going to be wanting for nades.
Indeed. You can see a deagle on Phelps, for example. They're going to stack everyone at B. And yeah, Manta's there, but the rest are rerouting back over to the A bomb site. Manta's still taking a duel here. And that's just providing more attention from the Games Academy. Ooh, through the vent, Showtime goes down. Finally, Lucas deals with Manta. The A bomb site completely under the T side control. And, well, I imagine Lucas is probably just going to save this AK. The rest look for some exits, but Bolt's is going to fall.
Yeah, no real point trying to just go for exits. They need to strip some weapons away. Or not take them away, but recover them. It doesn't matter if they really get any kills in this situation. They need to recover the weapons. Lucas, the only player able to do that. And now the next round is going to be difficult for the Brazilians. And knowing how low the economy is on the Brazilian side, Vex, that provides them with more options. And it increases their nade value, because if any nades are traded back and forth between the two, it's going to be Vex at the favorite. Looking at that money, oh, that's low.
Yeah, looking very hurting here. Lucas will obviously get armor. Does he draw? What are they going to do here? Okay, so he's just going to drop Henny and M4A1S. And that's the way they're going to go about it. So, do have a little bit of utility. Henny is the front runner in that regard. He's got a kit. He's got an incendiary. He is the mid player in that
ballsy
regard.
Ballsy switch up.
So, here we go. Ooh, yeah, Vex looking to, at least from the get-go here, five players towards B. This is for either the win or tie and moving to overtime.
This is a really big gamble. They haven't done this in a long time, if ever. I can't remember, but they're going to risk it. Lucas with one. He still has a teammate there. It's going to be Phelps, the newcomer, onto Zuli. That's the bomb down, looking for feet near the headshot. And Vex, they thought they had the bomb site. They haven't even committed anybody else. Now Showtime shows up on the flank. And Vex, just one member left, Manta. And they didn't finish chewing their food. They thought the bomb site was there.
Yeah, and it definitely was not. Phelps putting up the defense they needed. So, right when we think that one could come to a close, we got overtime on our hands. And if you guys have heard us talk about matches like this where you got potential upset and stuff, whenever you go into overtime, you got to give the more experienced lineup A little bit more. To be fair, I mean the lineup that's a little bit more experienced together. My understanding is there is some players on the Vex side that have been around for a long, long time. So there's that going for them. But I think that momentum's kind of resetting a little bit here. That was a big hold from Games Academy, and they're going to start off on the CT front.
And that's massive, considering their economy coming into that last round was almost not there. They could barely afford rifles on everybody. And that's what makes the decision of Vex all the more questionable. When you know you have a sizable economic advantage, and your A-take is looking so solid, and working slow is looking so solid, that's a really risky call. I mean, sure, they'll look like geniuses if they just wreck the B-bomb site, hold the mid-flank, and just dominate everybody, but was it necessary? I feel like they didn't take everything they learned on their T-side and formulated that decision. It was just like a call, like, okay, we haven't visited B in a while. They're not going to expect this. Let's just try it.
Yeah, no, I would have to agree. I think that's the way it went down. And to be fair, if they were a second earlier, I don't know if you spotted it, but Lucas was playing the front of like the elevated bomb site itself. Phelps was near the back. There's a moment where Lucas went from basically the pipe box on the far left back over to default, and he looks back at his teammate. And the second he looks back towards B main is when they start flooding out. So he had a very small window where he could have been completely blindsided there. And, of course, game of milliseconds, just how it goes. I think that's why he only got one in that situation, kind of caught off guard. But nonetheless, we're going to see an auto sniper on Lucas.
Yeah, so I guess the Vex Gaming surprise factor did have an effect there because Lucas wasn't ready. But yeah. Okay, we got an auto in the hands of Lucas, and that's a big enough gun to hold B by yourself, taking a risky peek, but nobody on the Vex side is peeking themselves. And I love this play from Games Academy. The likelihood of Vex late round hitting the A bomb site, I'm giving it at least 70%. Maybe not with that frag, though.
Yeah, and that was such a sick set play. Bolts playing outside of the door, just opens it up the minute a flashbang is about to fly on three. It pops on the other side with no chance at all for the T to react. Fully white screen is Manta, and Bolts gets a freebie. So, nice set play, teamwork to start off the round. And now it's basically not sit back and relax, but you don't really need to go for anything else. They're actually playing just solo B with that auto sniper. Which, to be fair, if Lucas can just scare the hell out of them by killing one player, that could be enough. But we'll see if they decide to head back there. Right now, Vex does have the bomb in A main, but looks like they're exiting.
They might be heading back.
They're juking me.
There's actually less players at the beginning of the round there for Games Academy at A. But they, last time they went B and got destroyed, but they're going to go for it once more. A lot of this round relies on Phantas. Can he keep all three players here? But Games Academy, this is the right read from them because the likelihood of Vex going to the A is really high. Can these two B players hold again is the question.
Yeah, Lucas able to avoid that pop flash. And Showtime's going to be holding the cross for him. I don't think he's let a single shot go yet, but here we go. Oh, he gets immediately dealt with, but the Showtime, lineup. They line up for him. Triple kill. And he will be able to get the SCAR 20. It's on.
Denied. Got alligator arms.
Oh, God. Being a little like a T-Rex over there. Just couldn't find the pickup. So, they won't have that SCAR 20. To be fair, though, Lucas kind of whiffed, and maybe this is better. I don't know.
Right. Shout out to my grandfather for the alligator arms joke. Also, brick for hands in the category whenever the Vikings would miss a catch. Tangent done. 16-15, Games Academy, Vex going for a mid play, but Games Academy have a great read. They're boosting on the other side. It's a whack-a-mole, and Fighter is the victor.
Showtime able to trade. So we'll be one for one, and that nade taking Fighter down to 2 hit points. He was already low, but, well, now he is struggling to do anything, honestly. So we'll see how this plays out. Elite and Killpo going to be an A-main as well. Phantas making sure they don't push through middle. But 4-on-4, and we can see that they're going to allow Henny to play the B-bomb site alone with that scoped rifle, where everybody else focused on middle and A.
Showtime pushed off a Toxic. We're seeing another round where Vex has the smoke wall up, but there's a big gap. And Showtime fully exploits it. Fighter just trying to run straight into the bomb site. I don't even know if he knew the gap was there, but Phantas will find the flank onto Showtime. Now they're going to try to book the bomb into sight, but Lucas already in there. Zulit goes down and no trade really attempted coming out from Our CT side. Okay, Lucas falls. There is the trade from Kilpo. Now looking at a 2-on-2. Retake nades for Henny, though.
Yeah, he's got an incendiary. He's going to dump it directly on the planting location. Flash coming in from Quad Bolt. Fully white screen. And again. But they're not going to peek with it. Bolts may have been able to be taken down there, but 2-on-2 still. They know one is at Quad. And as Kilpo, or if he decides to peek at all, he will, and Fanta's has
so
to exit
fast
through that smoke. Yeah, Bolt's excellent control there. Gets the double kill in Games Academy with another CT side round.
Yep, 2-0 for our Brazilians. I think Vex needed to get it done in regulation. To be fair, if they can grab this last one, they'll have an okay shot on the CT side. We'll just need to win two, but they cannot. I just don't think the Brazilians will be denied completely moving on to their T side. So big, big round coming out from Vex. Fantas forced to just rock out with the Tech 9 as he just kept buying those AWPs. And now Vex, they've been shut out so far here in overtime, something they weren't used to in regulation. And this time, there's going to rush A.
Here they go, just heading right on through. Showtime with one. But only one. Trade it off. Bolts going to be the closest one to the situation. Going to be throwing that incendiary. Not actually close enough to stop the plant or anything of the sort. So they actually decide to put it out with one of their smokes. Interesting decision there. Phelps runs right past a player inside of the default spot. Not really sure. Just overlooked that clearly. But towards a main, Lucas able to deal with one fighter there. And he's able to find the trade. So Henny all alone. Of course, last round of the first half, he'll go down to Zuli to Invex, getting at least one on their T side.
Yeah, they got kind of tangled up there inside of A main. There was a great pop flash from the player coming up the stairs while Bolts was going to peek from the bomb site. But then Bolts got shook because he didn't expect two targets to be there. And all the while, he got flanked from Quad. Kind of got mixed up. Could have easily yielded different results. But 16-17... I mean, we could easily be looking at double OT.
Considering how close regulation was, that would not surprise me at all. But we'll see. Obviously, starting off with full rifles on either side. See if Games Academy can come up with something creative out of what they kind of learned from their T half. Seems like quite a while ago at this point that they were on the T side. But let's see what they have in store for us. Vex, all the money in the world. Are they going to go for something like the SCAR 20. We'll find out in just a moment here. Fanta's gonna pick up that AWP, or at least he did right before that last live on three. So just standard stuff. M4's across the board. Get that op on the field. Same deal. Henny on the T side. All right, here we go. Second half underway.
17. Just need two for the Brazilians. Games Academy want to move towards the A side, at least initially, sending two towards Squeaky, Bolts as well as Any. I think Bolts will open the door and Any will go for the frag the moment that happens. Nice little bait. I don't know if we caught that on stream, but Bolts shoots the door. Oh, Fantas. I thought he'd be juked by what was happening, but no, he gets Any and almost brings down Bolts as well. Bolts was shooting his AK. And he was going to bait for Any because somebody would peek into this door expecting an AK there, which would result in an easy kill for Any, but not the case. Fantas, yeah, just hyper-cerebral.
And the way Henny was pre-aiming as well was to the top of the toxic barrel. The way Fantas peeked it was kind of crouching off to the left of it. So pretty cool angle to take, and it does net him that frag. Frag into the T side, so 4v5. Games Academy looking to reroute back towards middle. They got Phelps up on the boost. They have Manta to deal with. He spots them, but he's dropped Phelps very quickly, heading up towards highway. And now it looks like they're going to bet it on a B-side play. Phelps burning quite a bit there before actually making it into checkered. They got two to deal with on the bomb site.
And kind of unnecessary damage considering they didn't go right away off of it anyways. But two players are spotted in the bomb site for Vex. Games Academy just got to clear out one more. Fantas burning its side up top, but he doesn't want to wait. He just peeks right out while Kilpo's not waiting either. Every Freddy from Vex is just rushing straight into the bomb site. And Bolts will bring down Fighter. I think Vex just kind of rushed that.
Yeah, I would have to agree. I guess they were maybe trying to save their player on the back of the bomb site. He's calling. He's fully white screen. They're
like
running in. They're coming in like crazy. He's like, help, please. I need an adult. But yeah, they just continue to rush on in. And Games Academy, maybe a lesser team, might be hyper-focused that there's a player still on the back of the bomb site up. But, yeah, Games Academy not having it. I think they had one player that made sure that he didn't peek out again, but everybody else making sure that they don't get just surprised by someone pushing through a smoke or out heaven. And Games Academy now one away from taking map one.
And they're looking to end it right now towards the A side. Coming out of Fork, Manta dropped extremely low. Forklift, they get the smoke down for it, and they throw the Molotov down for the highway push, and Games Academy getting even more. The fact that they have the rotate denied completely, they have a smoke inside of highway.
Yeah, that's an excellent one. Fantas will finally breach it and off to the left towards E-Box, but takes a couple shots. Will hit his, though, onto Lucas. So that's Quad Box down. 3-on-3. It looks like Showtime will retake that position. Phelps, very vulnerable to Zulied up above. Zulied not taking a shot as of yet. It's Fantas onto Phelps. Henny landing, though. It's 2-on-2. Showtime, what a shot. As he takes down the player on Catwalk, and Henny onto Killpo as he attempted to take down that Quad Box player. 19-16, Games Academy will close it out.
And that's a really close scoreline for Vex. I didn't think it was going to get that close, especially being Games Academy's map choice. But Mirage, no slouch for the Brazilians as well. But given how close that was, we can't count Vex out of this.
Yeah, no, not at all. And I'm excited to see how Mirage goes, because we know Brazilians are pretty damn good on that. And I'm excited to see Vex. They've got to be confident. They've got to know that the Brazilians are pretty decent on that map. So I'm sure they got something up their sleeve, but we'll find out very soon. And just to let you guys know, third map is Dust 2 if required. So taking a short break here, but when we return, map number 2 of the best of 3. We'll see you guys in a few.